Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, my name is the Ripper Danny B, and welcome back to CWR Horizon, coming to you tonight from New York City, baby. Madison Square Garden is live for Horizon. Bye-bye. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your CWR Women's World Champion, the Panay Princess, Legend Jezzy. Returning to Horizon tonight after a huge night this past weekend in Cohasset. Fatality, baby, that Hell in a Cell match. This woman proved she is willing to do anything to remain champion, including risk the career of Asuka. That match was absolutely brutal. You gotta know that Stephanie McMahon is not gonna be best pleased, but Legend Jezzy wants to speak. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. There you go. The first two women announced for the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view, the Elimination Chamber match for the Women's World Championship. Stephanie McMahon laying down the law to the Women's World Champion right there. We will be having an Elimination Chamber match for the Women's World Championship. And ladies and gentlemen, we're not wasting any time. The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for a spot in the Women's World Championship Elimination Chamber match. Introducing first, from Boston, Massachusetts, she is the boss, Sasha Banks. And the boss is back after not having a match this past pay-per-view. Sasha Banks has been recognized as a woman that continues to deliver whenever she's in that ring. Despite having not picked up a lot of big wins as of late, she has still earned the respect of Stephanie McMahon, therefore has been given this opportunity this evening. But you have to wonder who her opponent is. There's been a lot of strong women recently. Sasha could be in for the fight of her life. Whoever it is making her wait, certainly. F-A-B-U-L-O-U-S. Well, that's a turnabout, isn't it? Ladies and gentlemen, her opponent from Staten Island, she is the CWR Triple S champion, the Princess of Staten Island, Carmella. A huge victory for Carmella at Fatality as she beat Charlotte, laying to rest those demons from the New Legacy. Right now, because of Carmella's initial kind of stab at it, Carmella's initial wound created within the new legacy, there is a real, real problem, a real crack, a real divide with that group right now. But Carmella is focused back on herself. This is not about the Triple S title. This is not about new legacy. This is about qualifying for the Women's World Championship Elimination Chamber match. And what a unique position Carmella would be in if she was to win this match tonight. She'd have two opportunities at the world title. Right now, we're going to get back down to the action. Sasha Banks is definitely in control early on, dumping Carmella to the outside. Now Banks up to the top rope, unusual spot. Banks pulls these out when she needs to, though. And Carmella is not quite aware of what's happening. Look at the Meteora, like that. Just like that. That very move that put Charlotte away at Fatality. But look at Carmella Luther's press. She should have had her bell completely rung by that diving Meteora. You can hear the crowd coming alive for it right here in the most famous arena in the world, baby. Madison Square Garden tonight. Let's take a little recap about some of the other things we heard from Stephanie McMahon as well. One thing in particular, Asuka has been diagnosed with a concussion, which shouldn't shock anyone. Between the attack from Emma a couple of weeks ago, the very same night, driven into the canvas by Claudia Thorne with the RKS. And then, of course, at Fatality, Legend Jezzy, she aimed for the head, she aimed for the skull, she looked to exploit Asuka's concussional past. Right now, though, we've got a cover inside the ring from Sasha Banks. There's one. Carmella fighting out. Carmella continuing to improve with each and every week, continuing to prove each and every week that she belongs to play with the big boys. Well, the big girls in this case, should I say. Victories over women like Sasha Banks in the past. Let's not forget that. As we look at this matchup, Carmella and Sasha have faced off in the ring before as part of a triple threat match for that title. I believe it was at Night of Champions. Carmella came away the victor in that contest. Sasha looks to turn the tables tonight and pick up a big win on the way to the Elimination Chamber. Look at that, those raking the eyes is Carmella. And a big elbow from Carmella, but Sasha Banks catches it. And look at that knee right to the chin. And a drop kick follows it up. Carmella was staggered from that knee. And Sasha Banks is feeling good about it right now. The boss collecting herself, trying to keep the pace where she wants it. But Carmella just too quick on that exchange. And uses the hair to slam Sasha Banks head first into the mat. And we've got a cover here immediately from Carmella. There's one. Not even a one count. Sasha Banks kicks out immediately. I jumped the gun a little bit there, I must admit. Carmella has her in the corner then. This could be a dangerous position. Especially now, Carmella going to take a run up. And look, she looked for the Bronco and didn't get it. Sasha moved out of the way. Carmella splashes backwards. And now Carmella fights back as Sasha tries to take advantage. But no, Sasha blocks that move. Carmella blocks that one and it's a forearm from Carmella. Sasha Banks into the corner. Is she going to go for it again? Is she looking to hit it one more time? It looks like Carmella is going to back up now. This time she connects. Sasha Banks crushed into the corner by that Bronco. Carmella follows it with a leg drop. Banks, though, up and out of nowhere, there's a hurricanrana from Sasha Banks. The boss, suddenly in control of this thing, goes for the forearm, but Carmella has it scouted. And this is the thing, everybody continues to underestimate Carmella, but she is one hell of a competitor. She is proving each and every week why she deserves to be one of the best. But look at that from Sasha, just shoved her into the corner. Shoved her halfway across the ring. And a drop kick there. Carmella is down. Sasha Banks taking a moment to catch her breath. Forearm smash there, southpaw. Not the natural style for Sasha Banks, but if it's effective, it's effective, man. Now Banks using the ropes for that spinning arm drag off the top. Beautiful move there from Sasha Banks. We've got a cover now. There's 1, 2. Carmella not done yet, but Sasha Banks certainly has taken control of this matchup now. Forearm from Sasha. There's a big clothesline taking down the Triple S champion. Let's not forget, the other side effect of winning this match for Sasha Banks would be that she has pinned the Triple S champion. But we have a cover here from Carmella. There's 1, 2. Sasha Banks able to just pop out of the move there just before the 3 count. That crucifix, though, came out of nowhere. Carmella again proving that she can be dangerous in the right situations. As I was saying, Sasha could pick up a win over the Triple S champion tonight. And while Carmella still holds on to that belt, that could be a huge for Sasha, who is still looking to climb the mountain. But look at Sasha Banks here. After an exchange of blows from the two, Bankrupt connects. And Sasha, there she goes. If she's got the wherewithal, she always goes for that. Stacks her up. There's 2, 3. That was a big, big win tonight for Sasha Banks. Look at that there, the tilt-a-whirl inverted DDT there. It's a beautiful move. This was the second time. No, that was the first time there. That Bronco Buster, Sasha Banks, scurried out of the way, sending Carmella crashing into the mat. But Carmella was able to regain control and hits it the second time round. Sasha Banks would fight back with that springboard arm drag. I don't even necessarily know what to call that, but it's pretty. Carmella was on the end of the Bankrupt there, though, and this is where it is really important. While Carmella was still recovering from the impact, Sasha stacks her up on her neck using her entire body weight for leverage, and it's able to put down the Triple S champion. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner and qualifying for the Elimination Chamber match, Sasha Banks. And there you have it now, Sasha Banks in the matchup. She joins Asuka and the defending champion. We have 3 spots left to fill, and I'm being told we will fill 2 more of those by the end of tonight. But now we have to move on as Dana Brooke is making her way to ringside, microphone in hand. Dana Brooke, of course, put on a stellar performance against Nia Jax at the pay-per-view at Fatality, nearly snatching the Patriot title. People aren't happy with how she got to that match in the first place, but she proved she belonged when she got there. Dana Brooke has something to say, and of course, we always give them the floor. Like certain someone has an issue with that statement. The Patriot champion is in the house. Whoa, hang on a minute. Dana Brooke just rammed that microphone into the skull of Nia Jax. And now look at Dana on the attack. And that's exactly what Dana Brooke is on about. The fact that she can get Nia Jax, the 270-pound frame of Nia Jax, up off the canvas. And now Dana Brooke with that handspring elbow drop there. There certainly is a level of disdain between these two. Nia Jax saying she doesn't have a reason to beat Dana again, and Dana is giving her one right now. And look at that up on the shoulders, look at that strength from Dana Brooke. Slams her back to the mat. And just going after Nia now, just working on those legs. She could be trying to harm the champion here. And that could be something. That could put Nia Jax on the defensive. Meaning there is another match if Dana Brooke is able to gain another match. But to be honest with you, if Nia faces anyone, she could be in more trouble. Now Nia trying to get out of harm's way. And it looks like Nia Jax is going to finally try and start fight back. They clash. Dana Brooke levels it with a big clothesline now. There's a referee out there finally pulling them apart. We're going to go. There you have it. We're actually having a cutaway to make sure we can deal with the situation. And of course, don't forget to tune in to Asylum's brand specific pay-per-view, I guess, this Sunday. Imperial Anarchy. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for 1-4. Introducing first from Concord, California, All Red Everything, Eva Marie. Now let's be honest with you, this is not a woman that's had a lot of luck in the Revolution. Or anywhere else for that matter. But Eva Marie is here this evening. Now, she has requested an opportunity to prove herself. How smart that is, I don't really know, because, well, let's be honest with you, she's not exactly very good at the ring. We've seen Eva Marie team with Summer Rae on occasion as Red and Gold and come up short against a variety of different teams. Eva Marie requested this matchup and, well, she left it to Stephanie McMahon to choose an opponent for her. The mood Stephanie is in tonight, however, that certainly could have been a big mistake for Eva Marie. The Red Queen, though, looks confident. She always does. And you got to think, she knows her ability level. She's got to have a plan up her sleeve. Well, you heard the crowd come alive there, didn't you? Ladies and gentlemen, her opponent this evening from Cameron, North Carolina, Lita! It's been a little while since we've seen the Queen of Extreme here in CWR. The former Women's World Champion looks to get right back into the action tonight. Eva Marie requested anyone whatsoever, and she got better than anyone. She got one of the best, one of the greatest of all time. If anybody out there knows me, you know that I consider Lita to be one of the greatest female performers, if not the single greatest female performer of all time. So this should be interesting. The match is underway with Eva and Lita, and look at this, Eva Marie straight away using that superior strength. Now, there's one thing you can give Eva Marie, is she is a fairly strong woman. She knows what she's doing. But, you know, the skill level problem has to come into play. And Lita now taking advantage of that situation. The Queen of Extreme, though, finds herself on the defense once again. And did you see that there? Lita's head bounced off the ropes before crashing into the canvas there. That looked absolutely nasty. Lita still manages to stack up Eva Marie with a crucifix now, and the Queen of Extreme straight into a submission hold. How many other women would honestly compete still continue to compete after an injury like that. That looked like it hurt, looked like there could be a problem, and I think Eva Marie has honed in on that issue now with that DDT. We do not need another head injury in the women's division. Seriously. Start getting sued or something. Later though, spear right to the midsection of Eva Marie. That was beautifully done. Now Lita going to go up top, went for the tope con hilo, and Eva moved out of the way. Regardless of any potential injury or not though, you've got to think this is rather spectacular from Eva Marie at the moment. Lita has her up on the shoulders, power bomb, and that was just nasty. But again, Eva keeps managing to fight back. What's going on here? I'm a little confused. I don't know what I'm calling. You would just expect with her in this ring that it would be a squash match. To be honest with you, I don't even know why she's on the payroll. We have a cover now from Eva Marie. There's one. Lita kicks out with authority at one, but the fact that Eva was able to get her down for the cover is quite telling of how this match is going right now. Eva Marie continuing to use those strikes to the midsection of Lita. And there, boot right to the face, absolutely no remorse. The Queen of Extreme flies back into the competition with the Hurricanrana. Onto the apron again, and once again, nope, misses. What is up with Lita there? Her judgment was way off. That shouldn't have been a problem for her whatsoever, but she completely overestimated where Eva Marie was. Doesn't seem to have mattered too much though. Lita low, that she just, did you see that? She went to leap into the air for whatever reason. Eva hit her with the boot and then came off the top rope. Now look, that is atypical of Eva Marie, just crashing into the mat, and Lita levels her with a drop kick. And now Lita looks to end this one. Twist of fate. Feeling a little too confident there, I think, is Lita. Because look, Eva Marie is moving away. She is getting away from harm. No, I don't know how it's happening, but it is. So get used to it. Now Lita sending Eva Marie to the outside. And what has Lita got planned here? Lita looks like she's sizing up the ropes. She runs them. And a suicide dive from Lita. Eva Marie is out. But Lita has to win this thing inside the ring, and I think she knows it. Eva sent right back in. Lita gonna follow her in. Look at Eva. Hang on. Where's Eva coming from there? Eva Marie has turned this thing around. Eva DDT. And the Red Queen suddenly is in control, despite being flattened with a suicide dive on the outside. I honestly cannot believe what I am calling right now. I cannot believe what I am witnessing. If Lita loses this matchup, what has that got to do? Sliced bread number two from Eva Marie. Hits it perfectly. There's one, two. Lita just about kicks out there, but whoo, we all held our breath for a second there, didn't we? I could already feel the entire internet wrestling community taking to their keyboards in an outrage. Lita goes for the chop block, but look at that from Eva, just turns it around, and a knee right to the side of the skull of Lita there. Eva Marie, once again in control, runs back. Double axe handle right to the stomach area, I think. I'm not entirely sure. Either way, Eva seems to have no specific plan of attack, but somehow is still in this thing. We've got a cover here. And now Eva with her feet on the ropes. The referee hasn't seen it. There's one, two, three. Eva Marie nearly stole that one from Lita. But now the Queen of Extreme needs to regroup. She needs to regather herself, because she is being embarrassed this evening. And there is no other word to describe it. It is an embarrassment. Now Lita, Spiderplex off the top. Done to perfection. Now Lita with a big body splash to follow it up. Here's the cover from the Queen of Extreme. There's one, two. And somehow, I don't even think that was really a kick out, but it was something. And now Eva Marie's spinebuster. Lita fights back. Now Lita's starting to build a little bit of confidence, which she should stop being confident and start, you know, being a little bit more aggressive. I think she needs to turn this thing around and win it. Twist of fate connects. Lita not going for the cover there, and that could have been a mistake, because Eva found a way to fight back. Drop kick misses. Eva Marie, she's going to go for it again. Slice spread number two connects. I don't believe what I'm seeing here. There's one, two, three. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, I have to say that it's a very good job you cannot see my face, because I cannot believe what the hell that we have just witnessed. Despite Lita going hell for leather at points, Eva Marie has just picked up a win off the slice spread. She couldn't even hit that right. She hung her own feet up in the top rope there. But it was enough. Lita was stunned and was pinned in the middle of that ring by her. I'm lost for words, man. Aye. Well, with that behind us, we have to move on to our main event this evening. The following contest, ladies and gentlemen, is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. And it is for not only the CWR Women's Tag Team Championships, but is also an Elimination Chamber qualifying matchup. Introducing first the challengers, representing the new legacy, Charlotte and Tamina. Charlotte, nope, no it's not. Natalia and Tamina, my greatest apologies there. Natalia and Tamina, the former women's tag team champions, lost those belts at Fatality to obviously the new tag team champions, their opponents this evening. Their stranglehold over the tag team division came to an end. Tonight, they look to regain those titles in their upcoming match. And their opponents first from San Diego. Sorry, again, mistake. I'm making a lot of them tonight, aren't I? From San Jose, California. She is one half of the women's tag team champions. It's Bayley. For the second time, Bayley holds those tag team championships, proving that no matter what the situation, no matter who the partner, on any given night, Bayley could be the best in the world at what she does. The crowd, as always, here in Madison Square Garden, alive for Bayley. and her tag team partner from Dublin, Ireland. She is the other half of the women's tag team champions, the Irish Last Kicker, Becky Lynch. 3 times a champion, Becky Lynch becomes one of the few people to have held a championship 3 different times, 2 Patriot title reigns, and now women's tag team champion. The Irish Last Kicker on top of the world right now. It was Becky that suggested that it was the time to strike. Bailey was the one that said, you know what, I agree, let's make it happen, and look what they did between them. There you have it. This is, yes, of course, the Women's Tag Team Championship match. As we said before, though, this is also an Elimination Chamber qualifying matchup. Double prizes tonight for everybody involved. Natalya Tamina, ready to start this thing off. There is Becky and Bailey, the tag team champions. This looks like it is going to be a Revolution Rules tag team matchup as well, which means no disqualifications, no countouts. All women are legal. Pinfall must take place inside the ring. 1 fall to a finish, and now Becky Lynch. Look at that from Becky Lynch straight away. Just flies over the top. Corkscrew from Becky Lynch sends Tamina reeling. Now inside the ring. What I'm going to do in this matchup is I'm going to focus my energies more on inside the ring, because that is where the end of the match could occur. But then again, you don't necessarily want to ignore the table being pulled out by Becky Lynch. But look at that from Tamina onto the face of Becky Lynch. Lynch crashes into that table. Now Lynch in serious trouble inside the ring, though. You've got Bailey being taken apart by Natalya. Becky trying to fight back. She needs to. We're saying that. Look at this. Bailey now fighting back. Luther's press. Tamina on the outside now has that table, but Becky Lynch uses her own body as a sacrificial lawn dart to take out Tamina. Going through the table to do it. Now Bailey inside the ring, getting a couple of elbows to the face for her trouble. The technical mastery of both Bailey and Natalya going to come into play here. There's the Dragonplex. Butterfly suplex, should I say. Completely apologize. I am on Mistake City tonight. It's this New York atmosphere, baby. We're coming off big fatality matchups. We've got the Elimination Chamber just around the corner. Big dropkick there from Bailey to Natalya. We've got the first cover of the matchup now inside the ring. There's one. Natalya able to kick out quite easily as Becky continues to take it to Tamina on the outside. And now Dana, I don't know where I'm going with that, but Tamina has just been put through the table by Becky Lynch. Natalya has been thrown off the top by Bailey. We're back inside the ring completely now. We've got a cover here from Becky on Tamina, who's just crashed through that table. There's one. Not quite yet, but damage could be done now. Natalya trying to fight back, but Bailey keeps on the pressure. Becky also keeping the pressure on Tamina on the background there. Now, Becky Lynch trying to take advantage of Tamina. Tamina's still recovering. And look at that from Bailey. Into the corner goes Natalya. And now Bailey out of the corner. Should I say Becky out of the corner with Tamina into a German suplex. And Bailey is setting up in the middle of the ring there. Right there, right in front of us. Bailey to Belly connects. 1, 2, 3. And for the second time in as many matches, Natalya falls victim to the Bailey to Belly. You can see Bailey here, first cover of the matchup. It wasn't enough, but it was definitely enough to put Natalya on the back burner, get Natalya trying to fight back. And you can see here the Bexploder right through the table goes Tamina. And there was just no recovering for Tamina following that. She was able to kick out of the pinfall attempt following, yes, but there was just no fight left for Tamina. She couldn't get the offense going again. You can see there in the background as Bayley takes it to Natalia, Becky Guzgun for the cover here. It wasn't enough, but it didn't matter. And that was the game changer. Natalia stacked up on her head and followed up with a Bayley to belly. Bayley right into the cover, no time wasted whatsoever. Tamina kept deliberately busy by Becky Lynch over there. And whether it be in traditional tag or Revolution rules, our new tag team champions proving themselves. Here are your winners still. CWR Women's Tag Team Champions and qualifying for the Elimination Chamber match, Becky Lynch and Bayley. Look at the two of them, exhausted but soaking up the adulation from the crowd all the same. They know what lies ahead of them now, but in this moment they can just be the tag team champions. There you have it, Becky Lynch and Bayley added to the matchup, leaving only one spot. Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name has been the Ripper Danny B, and that was CWR Horizon. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and we'll see you tomorrow for Revolt. Take care, and as always, remember to keep it sweet.